الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده أما بعد. We are still in the chapter in regards to the virtues of staying away from the dunya. باب في فضل الزهد في الدنيا. The chapters in the virtue of staying away or from abstaining from excessive love of dunya, excessive love of materialistic things. And we're going over the ahadith in which the Prophet ﷺ gave the Sahaba encouragement to have more of a fikr or a more of a concern for the hereafter than in this world. So the next hadith here, reported by Ka'b ibn Iyad radiallahu anhu, he says, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن لكل أمة فتنة وفتنة أمتي المال. رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن صحيح. The hadith reported by Ka'b ibn Iyad radiallahu anhu, he said, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, for every nation, the nation had a test or a trial. Every nation had a specific trial, a specific test. And the test or the specific trial for my ummah is money, is wealth. And so this kind of puts it into perspective for us why we love materialistic things and dunya and wealth and money and amassing these things and hoarding them. This is from the nature of human beings, firstly. Secondly, the Prophet ﷺ mentions that this is the fitna or the specific trial that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested us with the love of the dunya and with the love of materialistic things. So it's always a very important thing for us to always remember that this is a test for us, and to use it for our deen, use it for our good, and never to let it take over our hearts. Another hadith here reported by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he says, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, أَلَا إِنَّ الدُّنْيَا مَلْعُونَ. Verily the dunya, it's accursed. The dunya, it's something that's cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَلْعُونُ مَا فِيهَا. And everything that within this dunya is also cursed. And one of the commentaries of the hadith is, it's something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like or doesn't love. The dunya isn't something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves or doesn't like. It doesn't literally mean everything's cursed. It just means it's something that's not beloved in the sight of Allah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, except for four things. Everything in this dunya is accursed or disliked by Allah except for four things. Firstly, إِلَّا ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا وَلَاهُ, in anything and everything that has to do with the dhikr of Allah. So the house of Allah, the things that a person uses to make dhikr with, anything that has to do with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it's reading Qur'an or hadith or anything that has to do with deen, all of this is not accursed. And then the last two, وَعَالِمٌ وَمُتَعَلِّمٌ, a person that is a scholar and a person that is a learner. These two things are also not cursed in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this whole dunya is accursed except for the dhikr of Allah, and anything and everything that is connected to the dhikr of Allah, a scholar of deen and a person who is learning the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to include us amongst those who are not accursed. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the tawfiq and the ability to use the dunya for our khair and not for our shar. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts, to guide us, to keep us and our families away from all harm. Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahumma, bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.